Hi, Shalom. My name is Raffo, and I'm very glad to give a sharing today. And my originally from Malaysia, but now I'm in Jakarta. That's the journey that I been chosen by the Christ and the road to the Jesus. And I want to share a little bit to you all about how amazing that the Christ could be, that how Jesus found me. Literally, I've been based in China for 5 years, and supposedly this Jakarta trip is just a 10-day trip. However, end up it became 6 months just because of the global pandemic. It happens, affected a lot of people, even a lot of stories that we believe that a lot of things happens, no matter they're good or bad. But somehow, after I get in touch with Christ, I found peace, I found love, I found life. And I want to give you a little bit of background. I used to have another beliefs. Literally, born is not in the Christ. But somehow, when I travel around the world, especially 10 years ago, or 12, 14 years ago as well, a lot of time, I go to those, I went to these fortune tellers, tarot, and ask a lot of time. I went to Thailand, Taiwan, Hong Kong, Macau, China, even in Malaysia, Singapore. Most of these countries I travel, I always ask for this fortune telling, saying about how my life gonna be. Life definitely is up and down, and somehow a lot of them give me a common answer, common information that in year 2020 is gonna be my biggest year of my life. And from the original thought, I always think that it's just gonna be like, oh, maybe I will have a big success in terms of wealth. I might make a lot of money from business. However, I never thought that it's because of Christ that it literally changed my life. So when I would travel to all these countries, they all say the same. 2020 is gonna be the big change of my life. And indeed, I mean that I've been chosen, and that's the reason. So come back to the story that literally I met this Christian's friend, a very, very close friend. Her name is Ibu Lena. I'm so blessed to meet her during I was in China last year. So we met coincidentally in China because of a business trip. However, she invited me to Indonesia, Jakarta, for several business follow-up upgoing projects. And that's why I'm here during the February. And when I was here, that's the time also started with the China COVID-19 case. And somehow the China COVID-19 spread widely, and I've been advised not to go back yet, and also China has been locked down. And after that, once I wanted to go back, but somehow Indonesia or the global pandemic happens. That's how it happens that I was stuck here. So during my stay at the hotel, Ibu Lena offered me, she knows that I'm gonna be boring, especially during the weekend. She's like, hey Raffo, do you want to come to the church with me? Since it's Sunday, you are not working, and yourself is like stuck at the hotel room, it's gonna be very bored. I was like, yeah, why not? So I joined, and that is the first time I went to Bethesda Church. It's here, that literally that's the first time I met Pastor Ivan, they gave the preaching, and that's how I feel. It was like, wow, so this is the church, and OMG is more like a concert rather than a church. And I can see for the first time, I was like, I could feel like, I got goosebumps when everyone's trying to pray. I thought like, wow, it's so powerful, the synergy of it. I never thought that is the Holy Spirit before. I always thought this, that there's something, the aura, the vibes surrounding, and it's so magical. And I'm in love with it. And after it ends, Ibu asked me, hey, Raffo, how do you feel? I was like, oh my God, Ibu, this is like a concert. But yet everyone, I saw people crying. I saw people shouting. I saw people talking to themselves. I was like, what is going on? In that time, I was completely known nothing about Christ, nothing about worshiping and at all. People sing, people preach, and my Bahasa is so-so because I used to speak English rather than Bahasa. Even we speak Bahasa Melayu more than Bahasa Indonesia. So, but even the church very well, they prepared the translator for me, translate interpreter device, so that I can listen to the English sessions. And I start to sing together with them. And in fact, I've so-called addicted. So after that, Every single time when Ibu says she's going to the church, I say like, I want to join. So that's how it started my journey for the Christ, to the Christ. Until somehow, obviously, for myself as a foreigner, been stuck here for quite some time, a part of the moment I was kind of lost. I couldn't sleep. In fact, I have insomnia. I was so stressed. I felt like I was kind of lost. I don't know how long it's gonna be. Nothing to relying on, even with my previous belief. I'm just a born belief that literally I'm just kind of like following the beliefs, but not really into the faith. Not really. It's more like passive. But somehow, after I entered to the church, Bethesda Church, then I felt that I'm peaceful. And after that, I'm a musician. I love music. I used to be a vocalist in several countries. I used to sing. And somehow, there's a chance that literally Ibu asked me, "Hey, Raffle, since you want like to sing, why don't you sing this song, Amazing Grace?" And she says like, "This is a beautiful song." So I tried to listen and I was like, "Oh wow, okay, this song is very mellow and I really like the melodies, I really like the rhythm, everything is so peaceful, calm." So I was like, "Okay, maybe I can try to sing." So I never thought these are worship songs or Christian songs until like I listened to this song for 2 days non-stop. And somehow in the middle of the night, after the third night, I walked to the balcony of my apartment and I recorded this song. So in fact, I also request, I hope that I can share about this song because this is such a peaceful, calm, beautiful and magical, powerful song. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. Was grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear, the hour I first believe. So nowadays, it's been more than months I've been listening to worship songs only every single day, more than 12 hours per day. Until one day, Ibu's open house, she invited me, and together with Pastor Ivan and also all other the team and all the friends, they pray for the open house. And in that time, I really get in touch again to God, and I was saying that, next month is gonna be my birthday. Maybe that's the thing that God wants me to do and wants me to give. I've been like giving an advice saying that I suddenly raised it up to Pastor Ivan. I said, "Pastor Ivan, can I request something in my birthday? I like to baptize. I like to do a baptism. And I would like to go to the journey of Christ forever in my life." And he was says that he immediately says yes. And he said it's his honor. So things going on. I'm so excited until really happens on the day of my birthday, 20th of August. So I went to Ibu's new house and we have the private pool. We did the baptism and a lot of friends came over to congrats me and to witness the happiness moment. I asked Pastor Ivan, I said, "Pastor Ivan, so what is my new name?" And Pastor Ivan, before he gave me a new name, he said, "Can you recall back, is there any moment happens in your life that literally you have a name before Raffles?" I was like, "Yeah, I believe when I was 8 years old, when the moment I attend to F English class, my English teacher asked me what is my English name. And it suddenly, out of nowhere, I just told the teacher, I said, my name is John." So I told this to Pastor Ivan. I said, "Yeah, when I was 8 years old, my first name, I call myself a John. John Chen. So this is not from my mom. And after that, when I was like in 11 or 12 years old, that's how my mom gave me Raffles. But before that, some of the time from 8 to 10 years old, I call myself John. So I told this to Pastor Ivan, and Pastor Ivan told me, Raffle, do you know what means of John? I was like, I don't know. John is John. And he said, John means grace in Christianity. I was like, wow. So he was like, okay, so now I declare your baptism name is John Raffles. So I was so excited. I was like, oh wow. And even Pastor Ivan said one thing. He said, Raffle, God has been choosing you is more than 20 years ago. It's not because of coincidence. It's because you've been chosen when you were already 8 years old. God already gave you the name, and God already knows somehow one day you will be in the Christianity life internally forever. It just recalled me back like 3 years ago, I went to Manchester United Stadium, Old Trafford. That is one of the dream come true when I watched Manchester United live in UK. When the baptized day in my birthday is even bigger, more than that, I couldn't describe. After the baptism as well, I feel that is a completely new me. During the following of the Christ also, I felt that I could sleep very well, very calm. And every single time I have problems, I couldn't sleep, I just speak to God. I said, God, guide me, support me, help me, brings me to wherever you think I should go, or even hold my hand and bring me out from the dark. So a lot of time when I pray, before I sleep, I close my eyes and it's completely dark. I off all the lights. And every single time I pray, I turn on the worship songs. And when I close my eyes, I can see lights, always. The lights is not strong and it's not sharp. It's just very calm, and it makes me feel like I can see the light. The brightness is like, I think it's God. I think it's God saying something to me, although I couldn't listen, but I could feel the peace, the calm, the vibes, the aura, the surrounding. It's just saying that, don't worry, my son, Raffle, you will be fine. Although you are lost, but you have me here. So every single time when I sleep, I turn on the worship songs, and even when I woke up, the song is still playing, and every day for more than months, and I found that that's how it makes me very, very peace and calm, that literally I have no more sleepless night, I have no more insomnia, I found a way to overcome all these things. However, that's how I started to believe, and to start in faith. That's how I get in touch. I started to learn about what is Christianity, what is Christ, what is Holy Spirit, what is Jesus, what have Jesus been done for all this long time, and what is God Father in heaven. And there are a lot of versions as well, but once I want to share is like, belief in grace, that's really, really matters. A lot of us, we always call ourselves a sinner or something, none of us is perfect, for sure. None of us is perfect, but somehow I believe Jesus did sacrifice himself for us like thousands of years ago. But still, if you have faith in him, you should believe in him, that because of him, we are the righteous. Because I believe if you live in the sin, you will never be happy. You will always live in the burden. But somehow, if you live in the grace as a righteous people, every day is a new day. Every day is like a happy day. And in fact, for myself, I found a way of being happy is pray and reading Bible. And I'm trying to build myself a habit. In fact, I've really made it. Anytime, anyhow, I'm free, I read Bibles. I read Bibles not because I want to show to my friends, just because I want to connect to God. Because I feel like reading Bible makes me peace and calm, and helps me learn a lot of new English words as well. Because Bibles, indeed, they are using a lot of advanced English vocabulary. And just a sharing to you guys, if you have nothing to do other than watching drama, other than thinking about bad things, the moment you want to think about negative things, the moment you want to think about the troubles, why not you pray? And why not you read Bibles? Or why not you watch the videos from the pastors that doing the preach? Definitely, you will learn something, and not just listen and go into it. Think about it and tell yourself, bring yourself into that situation. For example, the moment I pray or the moment I read the Bible, I can imagine how Jesus sacrificed for us and the moment like how he really been crucified on the cross. It's really, really pathetic, but somehow this is something that it happens that do for order the followers. Okay, so rather than that, being also a lot of time, even Christianity, I like to share. Some people, they also say they are some old way and a new way. But for myself, I really believe, not because of Bethesda Church is my first church, but I believe because of the grace and because of the righteous. If you really believe in grace, you will really change your life forever. And as a small advice, come back again. During the pandemic time, even after the pandemic, our life will always come with problem. Why you like to blame on the God, literally, if things not coming smoothly to you? Why don't you appreciate God whenever you have less problem? You might not know. For example, in instant, you might accidentally cut your finger when you're chopping your vegetables or try to cook. Okay? It hurts you. And you say, it's like, hey, I thought I'm being protected in God. Why don't you say, every day you went out to outside and you are still safe? How grateful you are, but you never know. Actually, from the back, from the shadow, the God is always protecting you, but you never know. Some people say, it's like, oh my God, I'm losing my job. I'm losing my business. I'm losing my big deal. I don't know how. I'm so lost. Pray. Pray and ask the God to give you guidance. Don't compare yourself to people who are better than you. Compare yourself that literally people are poorer than you, or compare yourself to yourself. Why I say so? Not because I'm on the God side, it's because how much God is protecting you, but you never know from the back how much things that they've been done for you. In fact, a lot of time, look at people sharing 10 years later, 20 years later, they found, oh, that's why that things come to the reason. God always has a plan for us. And by putting on the blame to the God is not wise at all. I call it stupidity. And in fact, why not you be grateful and try to think, for example, like myself, it has been almost 6 months here. I'm away from my two puppies in China that I'm so in love in them. But somehow I have no, my family's, none of them, they are here. I felt isolations, I felt loneliness. But when I get in touch with God, I felt I have everything, more than anything that I should have. And I feel so peace. And I lose a lot of money, of course. I lost my job, I lost my money, but I was so grateful that every day I have nothing to worry about hunger, about starving, about fear, or about any sin. So these are the things I really, really wanted to share, and I'm so grateful that I've been in touch with Bethesda Church and been in touch with Pastor Ivan, Pastor Jamie, and also all the team, and also Ibu Lena, and all these beautiful people surrounding me. And thank God that I could have a chance to meet up with all these beautiful people, to learn. And I promise myself, no matter when or wherever I am, forever, I will gospel about Christianity, and I will be eternally following Jesus and Holy Spirit and Father in heaven, our God, forever. As once again I said, believe in grace, believe in Jesus, believe in God, connect through Holy Spirit. You will find a new you. You will find something magical happens every single day. You don't have to do only the Sunday service. You can worship or pray anytime you want. Because I believe the moment you pray, that's how you found God. And when God be with you, you will be safe and you are always blessed. Amen. I